Good morning, YouTube people. Welcome on board. Hello. Welcome to this new day X4. Ooh, day 6, actually. Day 6 of Born. Welcome on board. Just to say something so that you know what's going on in this video. I did something that I never done before. I fast forwarded the game a little bit. So off stream, I was just running Sita. As you remember, maybe from the video yesterday or from the last video, day 5. At the end, we were at the queen, the boring queen. All I did was going into the Hydra, departing from the shark, and then going into Sita and basically just bringing the parts of that station we built to that station so that it's built. That was about 12 hours of fast forwarding, 12 hours in-game time fast forwarding. But the station is now built, and that's where we continue. So nothing else happened, only getting this stuff done. And I also had a few satellites. That's it. That's all I did. Just so that you know where we're starting off, because it says 1 day 11 hours there in the save game. 1 day 11 hours 54 minutes. And yes, so the last video, it was 23 hours. So that was about 12 hours of fast forwarding. Just so you know where we are right now. Thought that I'd do this from now on, from time to time, especially when we're building stations and stuff, just because, you know, I don't want to have you sitting around here and just looking at the screen while I wait for the station to be built, so that we can do other stuff. Look at the Xenon Eye flying by the way, in the background. I don't know why this changed, no idea. Maybe because we finished the Boren quest, or a Boren quest line. I don't know if it will ever change back again, or whatever happens from now on. No idea why we can't see the Born system anymore. Anyway, good morning. Good morning. We also had some hiccups. Well, if you see this video, day 6. No, this is day... Wait, where are we right now? No, we're at day 7. We're at day 7. Day 6 was... the day before yesterday, am I right? We're at day 7 already. Wait, let me check. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 is uploading at the moment. Then 6 was yesterday. And now we're in 7. Oh, day 7. Okay, so last video, day 6. I'm sorry. I don't know why Xenon are flying around now here. Like, this is the Boron star... Well, but Xenon are flying. I don't know. Yeah, I know every name. So. Yeah. Right. Day 7. We are. Exactly. Ah, yeah. Okay, one more thing to address. I don't know if I should address that right now because it's like 2 days ago. Day 5 did take longer to upload because we watched some SpaceX stuff, and some of that SpaceX stuff got flagged on YouTube for copyright stuff by a pretty scammy company or by a pretty scammy service and scammy people. 27 seconds of that video got flagged, and therefore 4 hours and 50 minutes were just useless. All the revenue would have gone to that scammy company. And the moment I realized that, and they also flagged that a minute after the premiere was already running. So that's why I took down the premiere and... didn't want them to get the revenue of that premiere because scam your company, like I said, criminals basically. Like, yeah, in my eyes, these are criminals. Right. So that's why I took it down. I was trying to just simply mute it from YouTube itself, but that processing took more than 12 hours. So I decided, and it was still processing, by the way, this morning. So I decided to delete it entirely and cut it myself, re-upload it, and now it's finished uploading. And now it's processing. So we have, at the moment, it's Wednesday. That was the video from Monday, which should have gone online yesterday on Tuesday, which will now go online on Wednesday. But whatever. So Wednesday will be now day 5 online on YouTube. I think Friday will be day 6 on YouTube. Then I will do Sunday, day 7, which is today. Today will be available on Sunday. And then the 25th, Tuesday, will be day 8, which we will have tomorrow on Twitch. And then we should be starting with streams again, maybe 29th. April, maybe 30th, I don't know. The new Star Trek game is also coming out. Star Wars game is coming out, Jedi Survivor. Maybe we're going to play this because this will be on Game Pass. No, this will not be on Game Pass. But maybe we're going to play that. Good, now you know everything. There was a lot of stuff happening yesterday, especially. Very weird stuff. I'm also in the process of moving from the office into the new apartment. So I'm getting rid of the office because we have enough space in the new apartment. So at the end of April, starting May, you will also see a different viewing angle, I guess. A different viewing angle on that one. Anything else? No, that's about it, I guess. All right. So, welcome on board, everyone. Good morning. Good morning, Wicked Weasel. Good morning, Arthur. Good morning, Kaynor. Hey, Zypax. Good morning, Zainzak. Locked Puppy. Good morning.
Captain, Morlock76 just subscribed. Welcome to the new spaceman.
Morlock, thank you so much for the Prime. Very much. Aerename, good morning. Hellbor, good morning. Manadel, good morning. Markbot, welcome on board. Sheldy, good morning. Smalley, good morning. Arthur, did I already say hello? Arthur, yes. Hello, good morning. All right. Wicked Weasel, thank you for the hydration. Cheers. New mug will be available or visible in the new office. Not here anymore. Not tomorrow. Leos, welcome on board. Sheldy with another hydration. Cheers. All right, yeah. So instead of having daily uploads now on YouTube, we're going to have every other day. Drinking coffee too? Well, I already had two coffees. Otherwise, I couldn't operate. This is basically like... I don't know if you know that guy, which is called Emmett Shear. Some of you maybe know him, some of you not. Anyway, Emmett Shear just posted something. It was quite funny, and I saw myself in there. He said, like, he needs a coffee every morning. Although the coffee itself does only last, so the effect of the coffee only lasts for about 30 minutes, but that's enough to get him started. And after he started, everything's like easier. So the first coffee is like your ignition, and it's exactly the same for me. Good morning, Rashi. Welcome. Yeah. Anyway, so yeah, like I said, 12 hours fast forward. We're here, and we're going to game. Let's go. Abukdaver, welcome on board. Good. That is totally what a coffee addict would say. Yeah. Exactly. At this point, I think I'm addicted to coffee. I don't know. But on the other hand, I mean, if I wanted to... I know that's also something that an addict would say. But if I wanted to, I could stop right now. And that wouldn't change that much. And I know that I can do that because I did it a lot of times with a lot of stuff. I don't know why, but I just simply don't get addicted. And on the other hand, I also can't keep up doing one thing all the time. So it's like good side and bad side at the same time. I can't really double down on something because it will just make... I would just get bored. And... same with something that should be addicting. I just get bored of it and I stop doing it. I don't know. There are some people that can maybe do this. But we're talking about something like coffee. I mean, right. So, gaming, coffee, this is not like anything chemical or whatsoever. All right. Have no experience with that, so I can't elaborate on that too much. But on everything that's just normally available and stuff, I just get tired of it eventually, and I just stop doing it. Same with cigarettes and stuff. Like, I was also smoking, but like when I was 17 years old. And then one day I just stopped because I was like, this just doesn't matter. I don't want to spend that money. I drink 2 to 3 cups of coffee a month. It's a psychological addiction. No chemical dangers are going on the brain. Thank you. Yeah, that's a good. That's good. Yeah. Crimson Boy, welcome aboard. Guess someone get rent in low places achievement again. I don't know what that is. Anyway, we're also a little bit late today. Because like I said, the YouTube video had to upload again. I started working on that at 9 a.m. It's now 1:20 p.m. So it took about 4 hours, almost 4.5 hours to re-upload this stuff on YouTube. And now it's processing, so it's still not done. 100 minutes left for oh my god. And that just for because of 27 seconds.
A few moments later.
Of stuff that got flagged on YouTube. 27 seconds. Hey Sean. Oh boy. Okay, so here we are. This is the shark. Like I said, I just undocked, that's it. And I let Sita run for a long time. Made about 5 million credits in that time. And this station is completely built now. That's all I did. That station is built. Defense platform, the last 40 seconds. So the station that we designed yesterday is now finished already.
We and actually did it.
Yeah. Exactly.
And they called us mad. Who's laughing now?
And that's all I did for this year for the fast forward thing. All right. Hope that's okay. Because you really don't need to look at the screen while there's nothing doing but just some traders flying back and forth. Okay, can we sell that damn shibby here? Yes, 400,000. Let's go. Good. Oh, and I placed some satellites just to get some wares because I haven't gotten enough wares. So I placed a few satellites in Holy Order space here and there to find some engine parts and microchip, advanced composites, stuff like that. That's all I did. Yeah. Took the Urukanji and just placed some satellites. With that now done, we can place a lot more satellites. Weapon components, that's also a good thing to have. And what's that? Solar power plant? No necessary. Then, hull parts, antimatter converters. Advanced composite, two of them. Interesting. Scanning array and smart chips. Maybe we can get one in between here. Okay, and then we're going to fly around a little bit. Right. We're going to set a satellite here. Smart chip engine parts. That's really nice. Then we're going to fly around here a little bit. Fly around here a little bit. Wait. Fly around here. Oh no. Yep. Actually, just do this because otherwise it will not do it. Okay, great. So that Irukandji is doing stuff. Okay, like I said, we didn't do anything out of the ordinary. So far good. Great, great.
Autopilot engaged.
Let's go. We have plus 20 rating with the Born, which is fantastic. We can now finally get the administrative center and build the administrative center on the player HQ. I hope that that's Heretic's End is still... Yeah, okay, great. They're not building anything there yet. Cost 12 hours, you know, it's like... It's a fast forward stuff, but nothing really bad happened in any region. There is a little bit of stuff going on in Second Contact here. There is some fighting going on, but nothing special. Right.
Boron Shipyard.
Yes, exactly. Nautilus, good morning. Welcome on board. Today's choice of ice vanilla. Nice. Kedwar, good morning.
Requesting permission to dock. Docking permission granted.
Oh, here. Boarding's still not working for me. Possibly I'm not smart enough. Hey, JM. Welcome on board.
Identifying criminal. Short range transporter.
Yeah, whatever.
D.
I don't need that. No matter what I do, sector security hates me. Have you tried that in a neutral sector, Nautilus? You need to be in a neutral sector.
Successfully done.
Hey, Stefan. Yes, English only. Welcome on board.
It's an honor.
I do it's understand what you're saying or writing, but the others will probably Hello. Not. We're like a quarter of this channel is actually from Germany, but three quarters are not from Germany. So, yeah. Maybe confusing because of the GameStar video that I did in German. But it's GameStar. I can't do English video for them in German. But yeah. Maybe weird. 0.1% from Portugal. 0.1. Wait. That means like 0.2 people are from Portugal. Are you just 0.2 people? Hey, Sukayo, welcome aboard. Somewhere car cluster is hidden, possible. Somewhere where? That's a lot more credits than last I saw. No, we got 18 million credits from the Boron Queen. So maybe that's what's missing in the memory. But we stopped yesterday's stream with a plus of 18 million credits just before we ended. Because we got that from the Born Queen. Belgium reporting for duty. Ah, Crimson Boy, nice. 0.00001 is Rassi. Welcome on board. My German knowledge mostly is limited to BMW parts.
We are elated that you have continued to be a staunch defender of the Queen. You deserve the utmost respect and recognition. It is an honor to present you with a new rank within the Queendom. You will find that this rank comes with wondrous benefits. These benefits are tied to the rank, so if you lose the rank, the benefits will go too. But with your character, I am sure we have nothing to worry about. I hope you find these rewards acceptable. Please make the most of them. You may now find that certain organizations within the Boron Queendom will take interest in you joining their ranks. Once again, I thank you for your continued efforts. We look forward to working with you more in the future. Pleasant travels.
Thank you, Mulugu. Mulugu. A small loan of $1 million from Queen herself. 18. 18 million. Now, Sean, you are my... Okay, I would like to buy a blueprint. Now, finally, defense module. Born as administrative module. That's what we need. Give me that one, too. Anything else? Anything? Wait, did I not got this one? Interesting. Nope. 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 Oh, wait. Hull parts? What about hull parts? I don't know. Equipment. We need L-class turrets. Born L-class turrets. What are we getting? Face turret? Iron flak? Iron flak turret. Is that good? Modern flak turret technology has not yet been fully exploited throughout the known system and is jealously guarded by those who have access to it. It's a highly effective weapon at close quarters, particularly against fighters due to its blast radius damage. But this is the large Born flak turret follows Born armament doctrine, improving more effective against shields than hull. Its projectiles are primed to detonate at a large location. Regardless of actual impact, this can lead to target ships being caught by its explosion, even if narrowed, avoid direct impact. Is that a good one? I don't know. Install Donia in Vigor Space without losing rep. Okay. One of those sponsorships. Wait, what? Does Kajar's Guide already have... L-class turrets in there. Let me see. Oh yeah, large turret Born. Nice. There we go. Iron flak turret. DPS versus shield 540. Ooh. DPS versus hull 180. Oh, that's weird. Iron flak turret speed disruption. Okay. Iron net turret mobility disruption. Dumbfire missiles. No. Iron flak turret. It is a pretty effective anti-fighter turret and the only elf flak in the game so far. It's highly inaccurate, but the blast will likely still catch the target. Or multiple. It is quite effective against shields, but will struggle to finish a target because of low hull damage inflicted. The iron flak turret has a timed fuse. The projectiles will explode at the distance the target was at when the weapon was fired. There is some variation to the fuse and direct hits are unlikely. The iron flak turret also disrupts the engines of the target, reducing its speed. This effect stacks. This turret also has a burst clip which remains unused until the rate of fire is increased at a workbench. Okay, interesting. Face turret that we will possibly need to partner with the iron flak turret is comparable to a L pulse turret. Even closer would be the Terran L bolt turret with similar damage against hull. But the face turret performs very poorly against shields. It is a bit of a letdown. This turret also has a burst clip which remains unused until the rate of fire, blah blah blah. Bad versus anything with shields. Oh my god. Okay, so we need both. There is wait, face turret, right? Yes, face turret. We need both. Bofu. We need bofus. And Boron L shield generator Mark 1. That's all we need. Engine. No engine yet. Thrusters, missiles, drones. Drones, maybe. Yeah, let's do drones. Consumables. Not yet. But I mean, we can get them anyway, because we will need them anyway. Consumables, countermeasures. Okay, then we have all of that stuff. Missiles, they are cheap. Let's get all the blueprints already. So that we do not need to care about the small stuff. You know, missiles, drones, consumables, and countermeasures are already bought. Okay, great. That's 7 million. Oof.
Pleasant travels.
Thank you. All right, Mulugu. Goodbye. I tried all turrets on the rattlesnake, and the only one that doesn't overshoot or undershoot their target half of the time is beam. Yeah, even the L beam turrets are nice.
Can but, I help?
Oh, Bozo! Wow! Oh no! I want to buy you. Let me buy you. Bozo wa. I want Bozo wa, Bozo ta, Bozo ba, Bozo da, Bozo. On all the bozos.
Here you go.
Thank you. Needle. I think it would be nice. Base a seminar for one star management. But okay.
Pleasant travels.
Thank you. What's my ship? Bozo wee! Where's my ship? Oh, it's outside. Okay, yeah, whatever. Shifty. Life sucks. Welcome on board. Good morning. Why not the net and flag in combination? The description of it really tells the story already. From the Ultimate Weapons Guide. Iron Net turret, a unique turreted weapon specializing in heavy disrupting the mobility of an enemy formation. It is more of a support tool than a weapon, allowing the fleet to more easily engage the enemy. Only a direct hit will deal hull damage. The explosion only deals shield damage. The iron net turret has a timed fuse. The projectile will explode, blah, blah, blah. There is some variation to the fuse, and direct hits are unlikely. The iron net turret also disrupts the maneuvering thrusters of the target, reducing its turn rate. This effect stacks. It's the lowest hitting one. Very bad hitting. The projectiles are fast, that's true. It has got more than 10 kilometer range. Crazy. I don't know. I feel like this is not really the thing that we need. It's just a feeling, you know. It's just a feeling. Just a feeling. Does anyone know how to reset the counter of captured chips for Steam achievement? Not really. I don't know. Yeah, okay. For the English speaking media. Okay. Yeah. It's not like, yeah. It's more like, yeah.
Hello there.
It's more like, yeah, okay. It only sounds like, yeah, okay for you. It's more like a yeah. Yeah. Hey, Slefner, welcome aboard. It's very lazy speech. Ask Steam support to remove your chip. All of them. And please wipe my entire inventory of CSGO items. Which I have like 10. Maybe. Okay, so have we found anything new here? We're in a defense platform. Hull part quantum tube. That's good. Satellite here. Scanning array. We have stuff there already. Right. Anything else then? Fly and wait here. Fly and wait there. No, wait. Yeah. Fly and wait there. Fly and wait here. Okay, great. Good. Need to keep my Irukandji occupied with stuff. Oh, and heretics end now. Plan build. This is actually what you know. What we could do. This would be really cool because how many things do you have? Yeah. We could be doing. This is actually really nice because you have like five connection points on your PHQ. You can do. One of those... Oh, get away. You can do one of those Argon, Boron, Perinit, Teladi, and Split. That would be cool. Okay, so... Habitation. No, not habitation. Defense. Administrative module. That's the one. What if I... Can we... Oh, it does not work. DMs. What does... Does that work if you do one of those? No, does not work. It's not the right angle. Really? Oh, but that works. Oh, hey, look at that. That works. No, wait, does it? No, it does not. Why does it not? Oh, because it's... No. Oh, no. The frick? What is this? Why does it... Why is it acting up so weird? It's maybe because we need to be here. Why is that... I don't understand. What is this? Where's my mouse even going? Oh, F that. Remove the entire sequence. My goodness. I don't know if that's right. We'll need to rebuild that entire thing. Why is nothing working now? Nothing's working anymore. Shit. Are you freaking kidding me? What is this? What is this madness?
Oh shit. Here we go again. Oh shit. Here we go again.
Exactly. 90 degrees. Why do you not connect?
Emotional damage.
Where is it? Where did it fly away? Oh my god.
Emotional damage.
What is this? Where is it? Where is the part now? Why did you... Oh my god. Calm down. Calm down. The frick is going on here? Stop auto snapping! My goodness. Why is it angled upwards? Why is this part angled upwards? Okay, we're doing it this way. One part. Two part. I don't know why, but someone just did a very poor job with exactly this part. Someone did a really, really poor job with this part. Should be perfectly fitting. Any split part would be perfectly fitting there, but not the boron part. No, not the boron part. Right there. I don't get it. It doesn't fit entirely. Does not fit that well. Why is it? There is like, I don't know what's going on there. Why is this? This is like trying to build a freaking airport in Berlin. F you, get out of here. And that, of course, does not work with this here. Maybe now the problem is... God, What's your problem here? Why do you not attach? Just attach. Touch it. There you go. And I cannot fit anything in here. I don't know. What is this part? Why can I not get rid of it? It has to be a green place, otherwise it will not. Okay, well, whatever. Remove. Cancel. Yeah. New start. Remove. And use this one instead. I can guarantee you this will not work. But okay. Of course it does not work. Because it's not the same size! Rage! Oh god. Everything needs to be rebuilt. Okay, cool. At least I get the stuff that I wanted. Oh god, such a rage. I haven't seen such a rage before. I want to do something nice with the administrative module. What happened? What? Why is this?
Still not fixed.
I want it to be cool. Like that. Yes. It's a little bit... It's a little bit complicated build. But we still have a lot of... A lot of upgradability here. Should have just used split parts. Split parts are well designed. They work together. They have the same size. You can put like one triangle next to the other triangle and put another triangle. Everything will be triangled. That works. Boron parts feels rushed. Sorry, but it is what it is. It feels rushed. Still. Especially now, like third station. Imagination broken. Okay, we need some docking piers. I don't want to do a docking pier right there. It is what it is. Master Walrus. Wait, you tell me we cannot see a walrus now. They're flying everywhere! We're not able to find one right now? Really? There you go. There you go. 800,000. It's really not that much. Just need some water. Water and energy cells. Hull parts. Playtronics. Hull parts will be the worst thing. Okay. Oof. Oof, 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 oof. Arthur, what the heck?
Hey there, partner.
What?
How's it going? I've looked into and analyzed the socio-political forces at play in the split territories.
What? Okay, read the chat more. Listen to chat. What? Shift is not working, you know that. Shift is not working. You were not paying close enough attention. You were not paying close enough attention. I was using shift. If you didn't see, it was perfectly 90 degrees. That airport is fully functional now. It only took 10 years longer. It's not even functioning now. Oh. Uh-oh. That's not good. That's not good. Are you... Okay, yeah, sure. Let's do it again, because it's modified. If you've not paid attention, I did use shift because it aligned at 90 degrees and it's the connector itself that does the trouble. Because it just simply realigns itself the way it wants to and not the way it should be. And that's why it's I don't know, it's like showing upwards.
Hey there, partner.
Just built yesterday my first hull part factory in Elder Rules that only it buys wares for my own ships. A good tip on what ship I first should build to sell for making money. Wait, hull part factory? Ship to build? You need miners for the hull part factory. Xanax, thank you so much for following. Some rotations are weird. Yeah, exactly. That was not on me. That was oh my god. That was the rotation of the station parts themselves. Wait, we're not modified. We're modified? Why is this modified? No. Why is this modified? Restart validation is off. Okay. All right. Restart Steam, you say? Restart Steam. Secret game files integrity. No, I won't do that. That will take forever. Okay, we're good. Okay. Illegal extensions detected. Wait, what do you mean? Illegal. Can I even show you that? I think so. What do you mean illegal stuff detected? I only use the cheat menu that's available, like. It's just the cheat menu. Okay, now it's not modified anymore. It's an old bug, but Ubisoft can't find a solution for it. Yeah, it has got to do something with Steam. I know it. There's like some stuff of Steam that says, hey, this is actually not working out the way it should.
Hey there, partner.
Arthur, can you DM me an email address of you? I need to forward you something. Wait. Modified? Not modified. Okay, good. Forward. Oh yeah. Oh, why do I have an email already? I know that one. All right. I don't know if the GOG version has it, but The flickering is back, and I have no idea why the flickering is back. I have no idea. This is weird stuff happening lately in X4, and I don't have answers. I would like to know more, but I can't. What's also weird is... Okay. One more weird thing, right? You want to see it? Okay, this is the base cross connection. Standard cross connection. I just built it here. I didn't change it. I go to defense menus and I can't attach the administrative center because it has got a different rotation. Are you kidding me? This is... Actually, it has got the same rotation, but the same rotation does not go well with the same rotation, so... Oh. Okay. That, like, I don't know. Okay, well, I thought that's more of a problem, but it just simply has got the same rotation or whatever. I'm now angry. I'm searching things. I'm searching things. Nothing is... that was too much. Nothing is... No, that was actually enough. Nothing is safe anymore. Also, if you place... So, everyone was screaming at me, shift, shift, shift. But I was trying that with this module. That was the only one that I was trying. And it did not align the way it should align. Because... As you see, these other connections, can you see the middle connections? The middle connections are not flat. The middle connections are like that. Like to be more, to make it more clear, it should be usually like that, horizontally flat, but it's like this way turned. And yeah. I don't get it, why it's turned that way. Here, even worse. And using shift did not work. And this is, anyway, a very weird... Oh, this is not... Okay, I see the problem. Oh, I see the problem there. Oh boy. Okay, so what you actually want to do is... This is that container storage. Mm-hmm. So what you want to do is having this one here. Yeah, and now you can turn it. Ah, okay, but that... Okay, yeah. Reset rotation. Where's the rotation anchor? Here, that one. Okay, so you want to rotate this here 90 degrees. Now rotate this rotation anchor to this here and put that. Does not work. Are you freaking kidding me? Why does that not work now? Because it is not 90 degrees. Wait, what are you? Is it not 90 degrees? Is it like angled? Doesn't look angled. Does not snap. Does not snap. Now it snaps. Why did it not snap before? Nobody knows. Do you know? Nobody knows. Oh my goodness. Remove and remove. But is it now 90 degrees? Is it? Does it work? Is it 90 degrees? It should be 90 degrees. Okay, you get out of here. Where's the rotation anchor? This one here. It's just, oh my god. It just got so much more complicated. Why do you snap? Why do you snap and the other did not snap? Rage! Okay, so, is that thing even necessary now? Wait. Get away. Get away. I don't want this part. No, stop. Stop doing this. Get off. I wanted my other connection because it looks just so much cooler. Why don't you chat attach? No. What's the problem, my dude? Heh! This is perfect! What do you mean? It's perfect! Is it too far? Is it too far away? Like, is it outside of the? It's not outside. I don't get it. What? It's perfect. Do you see this? Do you see this? Do you see this small difference? Do you see this small difference? The fuck? You see the one pixel that is inside there? One pixel? Wait, I'll make it more clear. So you see this. You see this one pixel? This here? This one pixel? Here? Here? Rush designs. Not thoroughly tested. I don't know. I should have sent that to 10 people and said, like, try to build stations with this one day. Just sit down one day and build stations. 10 people? I think there are enough people that wouldn't even need to be paid for that. They're just like gladly, happily helping to avoid stuff like that. I'm sorry, but I need to place the finger into the wound. This is a wound. Also, that freaking gimbal there is causing more troubles than it helps. It was okay before. Oh, come on. Now it's angled again. Freaking angled again. It's freaking angled again! Why does it do that? Please, Lord, have mercy. Oh my god, what did I do? Would you stop doing this, please? Thank you. And it's angled again. Driving me crazy. Driving me nuts. And now it's not. Oh my god. I just want to build a good looking station. That's all I want. All I want to do is building a good looking station. Why are you now not angling? Why are you now not angling? Why you don't care at the moment? I don't get it. Why are you not caring right now? What's the issue? Now you're perfectly angled.
Awaiting orders.
I'm absolutely not happy right now with that. What if that? Oh my god! Why?
Emotional damage!
Who wanted to? Nobody wanted to spin that thing right now! Oh. Getting really angry at this right now. This freaking gimbal is making me crazy. I want to remove this. I want to disable it. Okay. Safe. Oh my god. Oh, this will be funny. Okay, let's see. Where is it? Where is it gone? I want to rotate it. Where is it? I am my... No, not end loadout. Where is the rotation? Why is it second now? Where are you going? Yes, like that. Just like that. Give me a solid and a liquid storage because I need that. Why you stop snapping? Go away from that part. Wow. Yep. Yep. Even the music decided to just simply stop and not come back again. Here we go. Okay, you don't like that? Why? What's the problem? Stop that rotation. Oh yeah, there. Donk. We did it. Save. Okay, great. Walrus. I'm getting so angry at that. The thing that I absolutely dislike is not functioning details. Something should work, just logically should work, but it's not working and it makes me angry. Because it makes things so unnecessary, unnecessary complicated. Okay, I don't know. There's no builder around. Okay. Get some money. I don't know. When I find a builder, I will send one to you. There's one. Congratulations. Found. All right. Ah, rage. Rage against the station builder. Shift is not helping. For everyone that's writing shift in chat, it's not helping. Try to build it yourself.
Captain, old_man_gib, just resubscribed. Continuing duty as spaceman first class.
Thank you, old man Gib. And thank you, Arthur, for the digestion cheers. From Zypex and from... Oh my god. Too much water. Taya, welcome on board. Cheers. Taya, tell me the secret how you did it in 5 hours. Ah. Zypex, thank you also for the hydration. 38 minutes ago. Cheers. Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly, Arthur, exactly. So. The game is saying you use the long section or it will not work. Left connection is off by an inch. Yeah, I know. Oof. That was hard. Hey, Dutch. Welcome on board. Not see easy anymore. Is 60 degrees? It's fine. 60 degrees is like a six-sided dice. No, wait. Yes. Wait. No, 60 degrees like a five-sided dice. That doesn't work. Does that? Anyway, you have five connections with 60 degrees because with 60 degrees, basically every connection is away from, like 60 degrees away from each other. That would perfectly work. But not in this scenario. Hey, Santa. Thank you very much. Ideal stuff for German-speaking players. Thanks. Yeah, that's why I did it. For the German-speaking audience. Five hours on raid. Just spam the low-level campaign over and over. But... wait. I'm trying stage 11-6 all the time, and it takes very long. Anyway. Good. Okay, I actually wanted to build a different station, but here we are. Stuck with building other stuff. This station is completely done. Perfectly fine. Everything's good. The defense platform is done entirely with turrets and everything. Crazy, isn't it? Even the defense platform is done. I don't know if I want to add L-class turrets on this here. I mean, we could, but then that will take forever to get all the stuff. And I think we are not going to need it because there's nothing really going on in this sector. Reflected stars. Yeah, I don't think we need it.
Captain, Striker Dragoon 13. Just resubscribed. Continuing duty as Spaceman First Class, Airborne 07.
Striker, thank you very much. 5 months, thank you. You know, the second cross platform has space to put modules all around. I don't know what that means. The second that one. The ring. Yeah, sure. I mean, yeah. I'm using it all the time. It's like one of my favorite Bourne parts. The ring. Ring. Ring-a-ding-a-ding-dong. Okay. Good. We are getting an administrative center in Heretic's End. We're taking Heretic's End as our first sector, which is great. The Irukandji has found a hull part factory. Nice. And what else? Nothing else. What's that? Scanning array, Claytronics. I really need that. But how big is the satellite in this sector? Well, not so big. What's that? Soya husk, parent farm, equipment dog. Oh yeah, absolutely. An equipment dock. Where is the shipyard, by the way? Where's the Perinet shipyard? Isn't it around here somewhere? I thought it's somewhere around here. Okay. Good. Is that all we got? The Arcadian Endeavor. Bozo cease and desist.
Autopilot engaged.
A little bit of flying. Whew. Sorry that I got angry at the... I mean, you see that I'm passionate about that stuff and I really want it to work, and I get angry when there's just... When there's like something slightly off that should not be like that. That can drive me crazy since I'm passionate about it. Oh well.
Entering reflected stars.
Sounds like most games always something that could be much better, but the devs are like, nah. I mean, this is something that could have been conquered very early on by just, like I said, letting people just build stations for a day. Here are your station parts. Okay, you think they're working? Let people mess around with it one day. Hey, Amended Man, welcome on board. Autopilot ignores banned sectors from the orders. Is it like that for everyone? Yes, because your autopilot is not a not a captain that's actually caring for global orders. Your autopilot ignores orders. Yes, you can prevent that by you instead of using an autopilot, you use your captain to fly you somewhere. So you stand up, let the captain board it, and give the captain the order to fly somewhere.
Entering Towering Wave.
Hey there, partner.
Aww.
How's it going? I've looked into and analyzed the socio-political forces at play in the split territories.
Okay.
However, that is not a conversation to hold over comms. Let's meet in person.
Nice, Striker. Can stations with important plot NPCs be destroyed? I think so, yeah. Then the important plot NPC will just simply resettle somewhere else. As far as I know. Yoshi, welcome. Same with faction representatives. They just simply resettle to a different station. When you're going to do the Terran mission for a free destroyer? I think I will need to sell that free destroyer in this case, because we're only going to get Argon destroyers and Argon frigates, and everything else will be born. So, I think we will need to get rid of it. The ray beam. Oh, don't misunderstand the ray beam. The ray beam is nothing like, for example, the Asgard beam. This is completely different. It's not like we're not talking about Asgard beam strength in destroyer size. No. This is just something to slow something down. It's more like a supply weapon. So what does the Ultimate Weapons Guide have to say about that? What did Kajara wrote? The Boron Ray's main gun, the Ion Projector, is a rather complex weapon and kind of...
Entering system, Sanctuary of Darkness.
And kind of needs its own page. In terms of firepower, it sits near the top, but the ship gets only a single weapon, limiting the overall damage output. The Ion Projector comes with a special ability, though. It will greatly slow down any ship it hits. Even capital ships will lose up to 80% of their speed from a full beam, making them very easy targets. This will also allow a ray to reposition to a more Danger. Favorable location. The slowdown is applied per beam tick and stacks. Because the beam of the iron... What was that? Because the beam of the Ion Projector extends somewhat slower than other beam weapons, it needs a tiny bit of time to travel to the target. You may lose up to 12.5% of total damage at long range. Ah. Sustained hull DPS is 1778. That's not really high. Kilometer range is nice. Yeah. Would be free money from selling the destroyer. That's true. That is true. It's super mild.
Entering system. Great Reef.
Like any submarine force, put torpedo launchers on your Boron ships. So yeah, what I would think is a ray destroyer with like L torpedo launchers. That would be, I think that would be something that actually hits, that actually can hit capitals.
Entering system, Baron Shores.
Hey, Gelnak. Egosoft, did they release a new video? By the way, I'm sorry. The thingy is back. The flickering. Oh my god, this is 51 minutes. Easy content, huh? Oh my god. Should I show that? Let's do it. Not extension settings, sound.
Hello. Hello and welcome to a new video about X4 Foundations from Egosoft and about the state of the X universe and what's going on.
Oh my god, Bernd! Please! Please, Bernd! Not so close! I'm shy! Oh my god. X4 Foundations Multiverse Team Seasons. Join the beta today. Okay.
the development, and especially about the online multiverse team season. That's the really cool new feature that I'm going to talk about mostly in this video. Yeah, it's really exciting times for us at the moment. We just released X4 Kingdom End, the big expansion that finally brought the Boron into the X universe, and also the 6.0 update, which was really major, big new tech update and lots of new features in the base game. But today I'm going to explain what Multiverse Team Season is all about, what ventures are, how you can participate in this, because we are going to launch a public beta, and you can join now or you can join over the next couple of weeks, and you can even get some exclusive ship.
Oh, please.
This is really cool.
Get a high pass filter.
So I'm going to explain how this works, what it exactly is in this video. So the structure of this video, I guess I will make a couple of chapters, will be that I first explain what ventures are, how this really makes sense, what type of a multiplayer game this is. It's a bit special, unusual, asynchronous multiplayer. So basically explaining to you what this adds to the game, why you want to play it, because it there's some
he really says cool, he tells there. You why
and,
you want to play
then
it.
Then afterwards I'm going to explain how you can join. So the second part of the video will be about the sign up process, what you have to do to join the beta and to get an account to play online. So first things first.
Well then, save, override, save. Give me a second. Exit desktop. And go to the MTS public beta, I guess. Oh, why is it on my PC already? I don't know. 25 megabytes, that's fine. Why is it on my PC? Verifying. All right. Ah, beta again. What the heck? Running from one beta to the next beta. It's all beta. Continue online save. Yeah. Let's continue online save. Beta forever. Well, better than alpha forever. Yes. Tatsukishi, yes. Exactly. As Zypex, I think they're using 40 maximum. Beta to beta. Yeah, it was just a few days without a beta, and then... oof. So, let's see. While this is starting up, and there is something really crazy going on. Hello. Good morning. I'm in my something. Doesn't really matter. So I already did a few steps to get that stuff here. Can we get music back? Wait. Let me just
Your
get some music.
Venture platform is completed. Now we only need a functional venture dock. Ah, finally. Construction of a venture dock has started. Since we already have a venture platform, we will soon be able to send ships off on daring ventures into the grand multiverse. I'm so glad to see you propitiously expanding on our venture research. I can barely wait until construction is complete, and we are able to send ships out on promising ventures throughout the multiverse.
That's new.
Your venture dock is completed. I believe that we
I did all the steps already.
We need to start the first of many ambitious ventures. I suggest we prepare an expedition.
Good. May I? Thank you. All right. So, what have I done? This is an old save, by the way. From last year. So here we go. Coffee Heaven. And this tiny thing here. This is the Venture Dock. And this is the Venture something something. I don't know. Venture. Boop, boop. Where is it? Multiverse map. Look at that. We are in a multiverse map here. I press control thingy. There is a team chat. Hello, team. Look at that. You can form a team with your friends and you can have a chat with them in game. Is that crazy? You can have it large or small, whatever. You can also remove that thing. Look at it. You can move it. Okay, I'm in a game here. What is this? Passive scouting. No idea what that means. Season reward. Also have no idea where to get that from. Operations and stuff. Venture logbook. Venture contracts? Contacts. Your venture inventory. Permanent items. Venture logbook. Season 1 has started. 47 minutes ago. Ah. You have joined Team Fun. Okay. Multiverse team season. Okay, good. Let's have a look at... Oops. Let's have a look at what...
Happy guy. Oh, just a happy, happy, happy guy. Oh, just a look at that. A happy... Oh, the happy dog.
Yeah. Let's have a look at what
first,
we can do now.
Let me start with why you may want to join. First of all, it's a fun new gameplay feature.
Fun.
Everybody who owns X4 Foundation can play. You don't have to have the expansions. You don't have to pay anything. And it's not really risky. You can just simply join.
What happens if you don't have friends? You get random friends.
It's an online feature. So it requires an online connection, obviously, while you are playing it. But
as in,
it does not
as in real life as in real life when you get thrown into school, you get random friends. Free friends. Exactly. You just pick a side and boom. You got a team full of friends. Hey Kedwar.
Very much with what you normally do. So it still allows you to play your single player game, and that is really essential to understand. Why do you want another reason why you may want to join the game and participate in this beta is because there's a reward. It's a season, so it takes a couple of weeks, probably about 2 months overall. And at the end of the season, there will be rewards. And everybody will get some of those rewards. I will talk a little bit later about how exactly this stuff works. If you join the beta right from the beginning and start with the first... first operation, as we call it, which is basically a chapter of this season story, then you will actually even get one special ship as a reward already at the end of that. These ships are a little bit special. That's something to wrap your head around first, because these are ships that you store in your online inventory. So they are instances of unique ships that you normally cannot get in X4. This is a new ship called the Yazur in this case. They have special weapons, and unusual weapons that you can normally also not get in the X universe, and some features which make them especially useful for online gameplay. But they are also cool ships in your normal offline X4 game. So they are unique. You can get them as a reward. You will get at least one if you just join the beta and start playing. So that's very easy. And there's you can potentially gain more and other rewards at the end of the season, which is about 2 months of gameplay. So that's hopefully a great reason to join. But more than that, hopefully the whole thing is also a lot of fun to join, play not just X4 like you know it with yourself, but actually with friends and with other people, either with random random strangers, so to speak, by joining a random team or by setting up a team together with your friends. And that's the unique new part. And I'm going to explain how this works later in the second part. So, okay, next I'm going to talk a little bit about what ventures really are and what sets them apart from missions. So to understand this, you first have to see what we mean with asynchronous multiplayer. This is not a normal traditional multiplayer mode that we are adding to the game. You continue to play with your normal universe, your save game. You can either start games.
What is this? What is this screen? I want that one too. Oh, by the way, and we're advancing to version 6.1 already. We're already in version 6.1 beta.
Freshly with a game start, like you know them from X4 already.
Yes, Dutch.
Or you can even use save games that you already have prepared, that you worked on years ago, that you are currently using, your normal universe. Any
wow.
Normal X4 save game can be used as...
Ah. Okay, wait. Multiverse Team Season FAQ. There you go.
We're taking hits.
I don't care. Why is it not? Stop that. No, that's the wrong one. Where's Bernd? There's Bernd. Nice screenshot.
As long as it is not modified. And I'm going to explain the whole modified situation and why this is important at the end of the video in more detail. But for now, this is the only limitation, really. Any X4 save game can be used. That also means you have all of the normal save gameplay. You play it as usual. You can trade, you can play missions, you can play the plot of the game, and you can play no matter which expansions you have installed. So probably you will be playing X4 Kingdom End Story at the moment, you can
excited.
Do this in parallel to joining the online multiverse team season. So what multiplayer is then there, right? It's not just flying into other people's universes. Obviously, it's not an MMO. You are not really meeting your friends face to face directly online. But you can send ships onto ventures, and you can have other people's ships in your universe. So what?
Wait, he's not in Team Fun
to work. This is what the ventures are for. You will see an interface later in the game, after the sign-up process and after everything is behind you, where you select ventures, which are a little bit like missions, but also a little bit different. And a venture is then a mission that your ships play for you, which take a while and which happen in the multiverse. So you are sending those ships not around in your universe, but they go through your venture dock, which is a special thing that you built, and I'm going to explain this in the whole setup process, into other player universes, and usually for a relatively long period of time. This is at least many minutes, and so they have a fixed duration, and you can...
Did you just say many minutes? Okay. At least many minutes. Atabu, thank you so much for following.
See upfront how long this will take. So you select a venture. Ventures have many properties.
It's a very long attention span for a TikTok user.
A mission, right? You see what this is about, what the tasks are that these ships are doing.
Captain Atobo just subscribed. Welcome to the new spaceman.
Atobo, thank you very much. Not only for following, but also for the Prime. Thank you! Many is two and more.
How dangerous they are. Sometimes you could lose a ship on a venture.
Wah! And, rage!
and what your chances of success are. That's very important in this whole thing. And
reminds me.
Start and off your ship goes. And for that time,
you know where I already saw this system.
Venture, now your venture dock will be blocked, so you cannot
and
play.
And most of you already saw the system too already.
So that's different from mission.
You know from
also,
where?
As you see, because you are sending this ship away, the venture is during its duration a relatively passive thing. You are not doing anything actively during the venture. However, you can also play missions in parallel, and very often the missions and the ventures play together. So there is something happening in your universe, and your ships are doing something in the other universes. There are, for example, mission venture combinations where one team sends ships into another team's universe for destroying opponents, for attacking objects, and you will then see your opponent's ships in your universe and have missions against them. That's a typical pair, and as you hear already, there is some conflict in this whole story, and that's
conflict.
And that's the next thing that I'm going to talk about, the whole setup of the story. What is this about? So there are two big factions in this. We call them coalitions. So the very first thing when you actually go through the sign up process, again, I'm going to explain that in the second chapter, is choosing a coalition, and those coalitions are at war with each other. So basically you are choosing a side, Team Red against Team Blue. You will have to decide.
I think we'll hear about that.
And your team as a whole is a part of this larger coalition. So there are many teams which form one coalition, and a team is in our gameplay a relatively small group of people. So the maximum is currently defined to be around 15 to 20 people. It's not a fixed number because it can fluctuate a little bit, but with the normal invitation mechanism, you have a maximum of, I think, currently 15 people for a team, and then there's a little bit room on top of that. Multiple teams form together a coalition. Two coalitions are at war with each other, and ventures are.
Did you just do that video like 3 hours ago? If I take a look at the
you get points, and
times,
really the gist of it. That's
funny.
Really the stuff to wrap your head around.
Okay, I am going to skip all that creating account, join the beta, how to log in, which game start to pick, how you build a venture doc. I'm going to create online save also and choose team and coalition. This is all very well explained in the FAQ that I linked you in chat. And we're going to take a look at venture explanation, okay? So what are ventures all about? So I'm going to skip those 15 minutes. If you want to see this entirely, the link is in chat. But I'm going to skip that and we'll fast forward to what is ventures.
Operation overview. So this is the menu that it's all about. Okay, so finally we are in the actual operation overview menu. The operation, as I said before, is a chapter
shiny
in the season. It takes usually 2 weeks to finish an operation. The operation has a story and a goal. The operation objective, which you find at the bottom of the menu or towards the bottom. There's also the team interactions further below that. But the way you read this menu is from the top to the bottom. You see the simplest and first ventures that you will probably play at the top, and then it progresses further down towards the operation objective. So the operation objectives, ventures are the most important ones and the hardest one to play, because oftentimes they require objects that you get further up, or they also require they require a progress that you achieved further up. I will get to that in a moment. So let's have a look at the top. At the top, you see, for example, brain fuel mining, and that's a very special category.
Brain
this is always
fuel.
Available in every
brains
in every operation. And brain fuel is basically
brains.
A method to accelerate ventures. there are ventures that you can play to get it, but you can also have brain fuel right from the start. I think for this whole season, every player gets a little bit of brain fuel, and in any venture
Sorry.
That you want to start, you will have the option to invest a little bit of brain fuel to shorten
oh my
the
God,
time
stop
that the
him.
Venture takes. This is a way for players to basically balance how much time they can spend playing live when it is important for you that ventures finish fast so that you can do something new again versus playing offline, because in the evening, for example, when you finish playing, you can start a longer lasting venture, and it doesn't matter to you how long it lasts, because maybe you are going to continue a whole day later or several days later, so you wouldn't invest any brain fuel in such a venture, and that's probably a good opportunity to play longer lasting ventures. And as you can see here, there are some that take without any brain fuel 7 hours. So these are then of course also ventures that give you a higher reward. Okay, so brain fuel mining are relatively simple ventures. You send a ship into the multiverse, and they try to mine brain fuel. And this is a relatively non-dangerous activity, especially brain fuel mining. That's completely non-dangerous. As you can see here, the risk of losing the ship is 0%. And the chance of success is 100%. So this is really a very simple venture. Here in the top of this rightmost menu, you can see the ships that I have docked at that station that has the venture dock. So I prepared by getting a couple of different ships and have them all dock at this headquarter in this case. And you have different ventures have different conditions for what.
I can tell you now already that I will 100% put something like I will put something like this. Oh, why is it not? Why is it not moving? Move. Something like this in the video. When I will do something about multiverse, and they're talking about brain fuel brains. Like a small zombie running around somewhere. 100%
types of ships you should have. And you can see here, any S and any M ship are
Nautilus, we're not there yet.
But they have to be mining ships. So that's the reason why only the drill in this case has the selectable box here. And now the green check mark shows that these conditions are met, and I could click on start venture. And this
brains.
Venture would take 5 hours. So this is a long lasting one. But because it lasts so long, it also gives me 10 brain fuel already. So this is a relatively high amount. I think we are going to change these numbers, so the numbers might be different when you play it, but this is always in comparison to the much shorter brain fuel rate mission, which in this case only gives me a venture, which only gives me 4 brain fuel, but for a much, much shorter period of time, only 30 minutes. So usually it doesn't make much sense to invest brain fuel to get brain fuel, so in this case I wouldn't do the same thing. But here, be careful, this venture is one that has a slight risk of losing your ship, and it only has a 60% chance of success. And this is actually something you cannot influence in this case, because it's a very simple one. It's at the top of the group. This is basically a roll of a dice. Will it succeed or not? So this is the reason why this pays out in proportion more than the brain fuel mining, which is a guaranteed success. So these two give you brain fuel. Then next in the list, we get to the tactical knowledge category, which is called team reconnaissance in this operation. And as you can see, there are chapters here. This progresses, as I said before, from top down to bottom towards the team, towards the operation objective, and each chapter has this bar here, and the bar is also what you see on the map in the corners of your coalition. There is coalition supplies, tactical knowledge, and oftentimes it also has strategic advantage. Strategic advantage should also be listed on the map.
Right to the right.
Coalition supplies are further down, so the missions in this category are a little bit harder. Tactical knowledge are further up, so this is a little bit easier to do. And as you can see, the two ventures in this category are called passive and active scouting. So this is traditional stuff to just to get information about your opponent. And again, you have different durations and different conditions for this. If you have a look at passive scouting, for example, we require a fighter ship. I can use my Discoverer here.
Yeah, it's all very small. It's even smaller on my screen.
The chance of success is 80% chance of, or the risk for losing the ship is 0%. So
it's very small. The thing is, you see quite big text on my screen when we're playing X4, but that's because I have a UI scale of 150% so they can read it better. If you would play the game at home for yourself, you would not use UI skill 150% usually to have more information on screen, but that would make the stream really hard to read. So that's why all my menus are actually bigger than that. If you take a look, if I go into the same menu, multiverse, where is it? Multiverse, you see that? Everything is just way bigger than on his screen. That's because the UI is scaled to 150%. So we can take a look at that later, because I mean, that's actually exactly what he was showing. There's the strategic advantage which he wanted to show. It's exactly what we see in the video, but I want to know what's going on there before I start anything. All right, we're doing that later. See the difference? Once again, my thingy almost covering 60-70% of the screen. Where is he? His thingy only covering about 50%.
Is no risk to the ship. Active scouting, on the other hand, again, we have to select the ship first to see this.
Okay, yeah, we know that.
Has a 10% risk of losing the ship, but also has a pretty...
I'm going a little bit fast forward, okay, because...
In addition to the tactical knowledge, which is the bar that progresses here, you also get team points. And the team points are you want to have at the end of the season to get a better part of the loot. The whole team plays for some rewards, loot, like I mentioned before, the Yazua ship and other things, paint mods, other things that we pay out at the end of the season to all players. And the better teams
get
a bigger share, and the better player inside the team get a better share of the whole loot that the team as a whole gets. So it is in your interest to be good as a team, but it is also in your interest to be good as a player inside of your team. Team points are one thing that contributes to this. Tactical knowledge, as I said, is this bar that will progress once you play these ventures. And when you click on ventures that are further down, then you can see, for example, I take one from the strategic advantage group, Fieldmaster here, and you can see that this venture has a very low chance of success. It has 30% chance of success. I can select the ship already, but I get a warning that I have missing items to start it, but I also get a warning that the chance of success is pretty low, 30% only. And to increase this chance, so to really have a chance to win this, I should increase tactical knowledge. So depending on how many ships you have and how willing you are to take a higher risk, it's much better investment to first play tactical knowledge ventures, get this bar up, and in order before you for the first time try the Fieldmaster venture.
Okay, so nobody answered what I was saying before. I've seen this kind of mission system with sending ships and stuff in a game before. Though that was not a multiplayer thing, that was a single player thing, and it was in No Man's Sky. Sending your frigates onto basically ventures. And that is in parts very similar to that. Yeah.
In this case. This menu, by the way, currently only shows ventures. So all of those hexagons with a V are ventures. In the real season, you will see that this menu also has missions. And as I explained before, ventures and missions oftentimes play together. But you, the mission is the stuff that you actively play. This is the traditional stuff that you know from X4. You can accept multiple at the same time.
Wait. Where did you see that? Wait. What? No, wait. Do you have a timestamp? Oh, wait. There. Okay, where are we at the moment? 35:45, okay. Whoa! Was that? What is that on screen? Why does it not say a size? When did it modify 18/10/2022? Busted. Oh boy, what have we found? No way. Oh god. Busted. That's probably the internal beta folder for something. Duck game. I like that. What is duck game? X5. Okay. Interesting. Just saying. No way. 35:45. Oh, Bernd.
Indeed, you can also mix the operation-related missions with other missions. You can continue the plot. You can continue your normal single-player session of X4 during the whole season. So there's no reason to do one or the other. You can do both together. Yeah, that's basically it. The same principle applies to the other bars. So when you see the ventures at the bottom, like the operation objective, then you will see that all of the bars, coalition supplies, strategic advantage, tactical knowledge, all contribute to the success of these ventures. So you want these bars to be as high as possible in order to have a chance to really succeed with these ventures. Because this venture is the one that actually gives you the highest amount of team points and also is later in the war effort, for example, the thing that really gives you loot, like paint mods in this case. So when you manage to play War Effort Venture successfully, you may get paint mods for your team or for your personally, and also much higher numbers of team points. The other thing
doesn't matter, Dutch. It's there.
Are the dependencies of items. Many of the ventures further down require resources.
Okay, yeah, they require stuff. Okay, we got visitors.
Okay.
Oh my god.
I wanted to quickly also show you how visitors look in your universe. And to make your job easier finding them, you should turn on the highlight visitors filter in the other filters category on your map. And that makes your job a whole lot easier, because then you see the name and the name of the venture, and you see also the name of the coalition.
Can you shoot them down?
Team that this is from. And as you can see here, even the player name, because I turned that on. This is my own coalition, so this is an ally, and I can
I shoot it down anyways?
And also see all of that information on my radar. It is of course worth noting that you are not playing alone. This is an online game, and this is a multiplayer game, so you are playing with a team. And all of those.
Remember, X4 is an online game. You're not playing alone.
Actually progressed by all of you together. So your team members are all contributing and getting points for that. And according to those points, you also have a rank in your team. The person with the most points is actually can change the name of the team. So there is not really a big hierarchy here.
What?
But if you want to change the name of your team, become the team leader, the player with the most team points, and then you can change the name of
what?
The team. And
what?
In the
that's so wow. I don't know if that's really that's really a good choice.
Progress bars, they are all progressed together, so obviously the better your team members are, the better you will be as well, because
playing multiplayer 24/7
make progress with the harder ventures further
just
down.
To call the team the brains team, all the time.
Obviously, there is also a very important feature to help you develop a common strategy to work together with your friends or your teammates, and that is the chat. We have multiple ways to chat, to open the chat window. You can map it to a button. So that
it's a chat. Yeah, okay. Come over it.
In the menus, you will also find the venture inventory. This is the little bag symbol here on the left, and once you open this,
brain
you will
fuel.
See that you have the venture inventory.
Say it again.
Which is permanent inventory, so it's important to note everything that you will have here. Like later, once you have unlocked it, this unique ship, the Yazur, but also paint mods and everything else that you earn as permanent items through ventures is available in every save game. You can always import these things in every save game. So next time you start a fresh game, a new game start, or you load a different save game, you can import those same things again. So you can always only import it once. So you cannot multiply your ships, obviously, but you can use them in multiple different save games. I always.
What if it gets destroyed?
Here in my inventory, and I can call it now. Every interaction with the inventory, just like every time you start a venture, will trigger a save game. This is necessary to prevent cheating. And you also see that now that I did call this ship, it gives me a message that the next
nice.
Time
hey, Legion.
I can actually call it out of my inventory.
You don't need to start it at all.
So I can only do this once per day. So I cannot immediately
hey,
into
Owen.
A different save game. But the ship is now available. In
you don't need to start a online game.
I have my venture
you just you can just simply
being attacked here. I have to
don't care.
Get away. So here you have it. This is the Yazoo.
Casually, Bernd getting destroyed while doing the video. You can just simply not start an online the online season stuff. I mean, you need to build. You need to make an account. You need to connect this with EgoSoft. You need to build the Venture Dock. You need to start the stuff in there, like whatsoever. If you don't do that, you are not taking part. So it's completely optional. What's the next thing? Reward chips.
That I just recalled out of my online inventory. Venture inventory, and it arrived in my venture dock.
Yeah, it's not
and
forced.
This is a
that's the next thing.
This is a pretty cool ship, and I can, of course, also use it myself. Unfortunately, I can't.
Hope there is no test
here.
After the video.
Research that first, but I will actually fly it a little
what?
Bit to show you this ship. Okay, so this is the Yazur, and we're going to take off out of the venture dock. Normally. Only NPCs are.
So we need to mod those ships in and done. There you go.
Of course, you can still teleport.
Okay, yeah, it's the Yazur. Blah, blah, blah. What about keeping those?
The Yazur, as you will note, is a special ship also in that it has already a very special engine. I can maybe quickly show you a little bit about it from the info menu. And this ship also has special engines, and these engines allow it to be faster for ventures. It basically acts as a ship that already comes with some brain fuel pre-equipped.
Brain fuel.
So here we have the Yazur docked. I already had assigned a pilot to it, so you can move crew to the ship, of course, like with every other ship. This is a requirement, of course, to send it to the multiverse. You cannot send a ship without any crew. But note that the crew will also gain a lot of experience on ventures. So ventures are an excellent way to train crew, including the pilot. So now that I have the Yasuo docked here and I select the active scouting, which is a mission that requires a fighter ship, this fits here. Then you see that without actually assigning it any brain fuel, it already immediately has 2 units of brain fuel. So the venture is now shortened to just 3 minutes from 15 minutes. So this is way faster. And
how often can I do that?
And so these venture ships
are a cooldown.
Really cool and useful, especially for ventures, but also in the normal game.
Is there a cooldown?
Finally, I have to explain the situation with modified games. There are 2 ways that you could end up with a safe game or with your game being marked as modified. And once the game is marked as modified, you cannot play ventures anymore. That's important to know. The one way is to install mods, and the other way is to start a game in creative mode or to modify your save game. So basically the custom game start editor, you may know it already, I think we have it since 4.0, has two modes, the budgeted version and the creative version.
Okay, budgeted online version versus mod. Okay, good. Yeah, we know that if you mod your game, you get like an advantage over other players, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so that was the most important stuff about that. Let's try it out. We're back. Hello. Give me some music. Music. Okay, back. So, brain fuel mining. We have identified a brain which boasts an impressive quantity of natural brain fuel. What's a brain? Like, now for real, what does that mean? Brain. Brain. An extended object with any given number of dimensions, of which strings in string theory are examples with one dimension. Our universe is a 3 brain. Excuse me, what? Brain. Brain. It's called brain. We have received word that the enemy coalition has established a supply route to keep all of their members well stocked in brain fuel. Brain. Okay, so how long does that? 30 minutes. Right? You have chance to lose your ship. Do we got some brain fuel? What is that? Venture inventory. No. Wait. Venture logbook. Operation. Team season. Xenon Slayer! Why is there a... What is this? What does that mean? What does that mean? Passive scouting. Ah, you're doing something. Healthcare. Ah, you're doing something. Okay. That's what you're doing here, right? Old Drollo. You're doing something. And Marcus is doing something. Okay, whoever that is. And you are doing healthcare. Okay. What is healthcare? Like, do we advance already into something? Send items to team members. Wait, what? Access to the multiverse enables you to share or trade wares and other items with other individuals in order to achieve your common goals. Add inventory item. Wait, I can send them my Sita? Because I do have 2. Send me Sita, please. Even Claytronics, everything. Wait. Inventory venture items? Flux capacitor and stuff. Don't let him suffer. Okay. War effort. Whoa. That's a lot of stuff. Kid. Resources. 1 brain treaty. This item is obtained as a reward for completing the following venture. Establish diplomatic relations. Escort allied diplomat. Wait, this is a mission. Oh, this is a mission I can do in my game, huh? Fly to coalition diplomat, talk to coalition diplomat, escort coalition diplomat. Oh, you get a seminar for 3-star crew management and 3 diplomatic documents, which you can then use for this here. And there you get brain treaties. And then brain treaties can be used in here, and that gives a lot of team points. Uh-huh. Roadkill, rising star. Roadkill? Tactical knowledge. 100%. 15 minutes. Chance of losing ship, 10%. Fighter. I do not have brain fuel. Brain. Active scouting. Okay, go. Start. Saving game. That's what she said. That's what he said. So you get exclusive multiverse ships, so no real use apart from venturing. Well, yeah, and I guess if you do this stuff, like this supply stuff, then you will get better things. I don't know. Where did he... Wait, why do I not have the Yasuo? How do you get the Yasuo? Wait, what? Where is it? Season reward. Yasuo. Experimental... How do I get that? The heck? So everything to unlock in that safe is only for that safe, right? No. No. No, 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 no. You get the ships that you can then also call in your single player. But no, that's not true, Ketra. How did the others got it? I was looking at pictures yesterday. How did they get it? There. How? Tell me. Collector's edition. Damn it. You're right. Why do I not have the collector's edition? What? You need to start the venture thing, unknown. If you got the collector's edition, you need to start the venture thing, and then you can download it immediately. Or you can get it in your game immediately. Hmm. Okay. That's in operation. Where's my ship? Active scouting. Old Drulo. That's technical knowledge. Wait, where's active scouting? Where am I? Where's my thing? Where's my thing? I mean, team fun. What are you doing? Sabotage talks. Ooh. Marcus. What's my thing? I'm not in there anymore. What? And why is half of the team gone? They kicked you out of team fun. I think there's an issue where you may disappear in the menu. Ah. But, like, half of my team is gone. Previous season information. Captain Call is not fun enough. Too bad. What? What? Can we please time out EagleSoft official, please? Like for an undisclosed amount of time. I also don't have the Yasuo. Why do I not have the Yasuo? Okay, I'm just waiting now. 11 minutes. Okay. Is there... Okay, wait. Let's see. Filter. Other. Highlight visitors. Where are they? Oh! Oh. Cabal. How do you distinguish visitors? Where are they? What's their faction or whatever? Do I search for fun? 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 Anyone? Anyone want some fun?
Emotional damage!
No fun? There's no fun! Why does he have 0 credits? Why do I have 0 credits? Oh yeah, I know why. I pressed the accept all estimates. I pressed this bad button and 0 credits came. Was the zero credits was the result. Cap was complaining about not having CE. Yes, I did see you trying to post my email address. Wait, what? What? Very few people fun enough. Time out for many minutes. Exactly. I entered Steam. What was that? Wait. On stream, we were taking a look at the multiverse map. Multiverse Online Seasons beta. We just looked at the video about Multiverse Online Seasons. Again, for everyone that joined a little bit later. I don't care, dude. There is the video in chat about Multiverse Online Seasons. That's interesting. Should we make like a picture? Should I make like, I don't know. How do we make a screenshot of that? How do you make a screenshot of that? Like here? Team fun. Just that. I don't know why that's happening all the time. Screenshot. This will be... It's like the most uninteresting thumbnail ever, but everyone will know what it is. Let's wait for Spiffing Brit to join. And this project is dead. Okay, I'm still actively scouting. What does that mean? Sabotage talks. Xenon Slayer is also active. Is passive scouting. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. But where is active scouting? I'm active scouting, not passive scouting. I bought the X4 Foundation Collector Edition content separately. Do I have the paint mod? I don't know. I think so. Any faction race can join any team. Yes. Put me in Spears team. You can create your own team. Yeah, you can also create your own team. I don't know how we're doing this when it actually drops. If we should create a Space Operations Delta team or if we just... I don't know. Join someone else. I think we should definitely. I think we should make a team. No, it's not Pythica. It's not. Click on the YouTube video link in chat, and there is the link to the forum post, and there is the FAQ how to join. It's not the same password. No. The active scouting pressed the wrong button and went to the quantum realm instead. Excuse me. Does that work with Sita? Whoa, that's also very, very nice. That happens when you get from the multiverse map and you press M. I saw that 2 times now. So multiverse and then press M and you have like... This is the entire X universe. That's so colorful. Funny, you can't get out there. A multiverse and then M. Nice. Very cute. Exactly. So, Sita, multiverse. Not working? Why does that not work? Sita, hello?
Something hit us.
Aranane, welcome on board. What do you mean something hit us? I don't care. Did they reshuffle? Seems so, yeah. There's special content for this new Planet Collector's Edition. Yeah. Team Fun was 6th. I know! Brain powers. Finny Graphics, welcome on board. By the way, talking about graphics, I do have now a command. If you write something like, oh, what is your graphic set? Then something like that appears and you can see it in my graphic settings. Isn't that nice? Does that happen though every single time? You gotta fix that. Oh, and you gotta fix that. You still in here? Yes. Fix it. Or I fix it. Nah. The developer's going like, nah. Okay, like, why are we still at 0% with everything? Are you not scouting enough? Venture logbook. Venture duration. Ships on the venture. Operation Overture has started. Our coalition has begun assembling its fleets. Likewise, the opposition is also readying its joint forces. Our immediate priority should be to establish an initial presence in the enemy brains. Brain... Establish an initial presence in the enemy brains and to fortify our allegiances with other members of our coalition. We cannot expect the enemy to sit idly by as we prepare, so stay on guard against any potential. What was that? Nani? What? Hello. Welcome back, everyone. Here they are. The multiverse is truly mysterious. Yay, I'm back. Woo. There's Arthur. Look, woo, Arthur. And there's Aranane. Aranane, hello. And there's Demon Slayer. Hello. Finally, Team Fun assembled. Ah, there's my ship. Yay. Tactical knowledge. We are now at 6% tactical knowledge. Good. Okay. Interesting. You have left your team. You have joined Team Fun. Wait, what? You have joined Team Fun. Okay, 2 minutes. I wait for the first guy on the low-end GPU to encounter 2 full fleets of multiverse ships battling it out. Nautilus, that sounds weird. Hey, Blade. I'm not sure what I'm seeing here. You see multiverse online seasons, the beta. This is X4. This is the standard universe, and this is the multiverse. Ah, we're doing tactical knowledge in the Rainy Coalition. Aha.
Requesting immediate backup.
We should maybe... I'm not that far. Well, everyone can join. It looks different, yeah. 1 minute, okay, let's see what happens when it's done. Ah, yeah, look at that. That's me. It's me. TVCD, Multiverse Team Leader. I am. Ah, yeah. Wait. Everything's gone now. No rank. What the heck is happening? No rank. No rank. Ah, everything changed. Again. It's all happening live. What? They're messing around with our games live. You saw that change? Ah, yeah. Okay. I don't know why, but I think they're watching the stream and they're like, press the button now. Boom. X-Force going multiplayer, yeah. When you send the carrier on a mission, we will assign to Wings a company too. Interesting. Check out the chat. Hi, Twitch chat. Oh, God. Xenon Slayer. Really? Hello, everyone. I'm excited to start having fun with Team Fun. I lost all tactic points, restarted the game, and still only see a few members. Hi, Twitch chat. Hey! We did our first thing! Oh my god. Mute! Get out. Get off my screen. Okay, we're done. View results. Venture completed. Oh, are you really? Really? Really, really, really? I want to see the spoilers. Failed. What? ...60% chance! That's a freaking casino in here! Failed. Yeah, congratulations. Can you do that again? Kid. Start. I did not got shut down, no. Optimal, hey, work on board. How do you access the chat? You need to... go into controls and actually set something as a hotkey. Where is it? Toggle chat window. I have a hotkey for that. Control H. Control H. Control whatever. Hashtag. Whatever it's called. And then I can just open chat. Crazy stuff. Crazy stuff on screen. Okay, let's... Brain Fuel Raid. Let's send one of those guys. Wait, where is it? Oh no! It left! Damn it. Brain Fuel 4. Enlist Field Officer. Deliver qualified personnel. Field Commission. I will need to get field commissions first. Oh my goodness. You know what? I'll just go and raid some brain fuel. Brain... Start. Top left. Oh yeah, you can also click on team chat here. Top corner. No nuts in Team Fun, please. Brains.
Requesting immediate backup.
Okay, whatever. Good. That was that. Now you know what this is up to. Multiverse Online Seasons is a thing now. You can join the beta. The link is in the... this is not it, in the video description here. Go and watch this video, what it's all about. Link in chat again, and join the beta and stress their servers. None. Good thing is, if you want to go back and forth, it's just 20 megabytes. So it's really fast to go back into the unmodified or unbeta game. I don't know how to call this. Rainy Coalition is just empty. No, Bernd, for example, is in Rainy Coalition. So it's the boss is in Rainy. So it's not that much fun. Okay, is day 5 good or not? Checks are taking longer to complete. That's fine. Okay, great. So do you wage war with other teams? I think there are some competitive things, yeah. But I don't know. Well, it we will see how much they are going to dip their toes into competitive stuff, and that you need to send like good equipped ships into battle or whatever. I don't know. Let's go back. Thank you, Eaglesoft. Oh boy. I love that song with the humming.
Autopilot disengaged.
Oh, you're loud. Which one is that again? Why are you updating Civ 3? Is that Ode of the Black River? Oh yeah, it is. Oh, that was... Oh, you got me there. Oh my god, you got me there. I thought, like, where is this humming coming from? Which tab is not muted? Oh my goodness. Which tab's not muted? What's going on here? What are we doing? That one's running good. Ah, we need miners. We need miners and miners. We need miners. A lot of miners. I would like to buy a roar calls, because roar calls, they're great. Roar call mineral miner. How much is that? 1.7 for the chassis. Minimum 4 million. Wow. Mining. Mark 1 shields are perfectly fine if they stick in wait. So another thing that I would really like to do is now, especially with the Boron equipment, is I would like to choose every single turret myself. Because now I can't do like one iron pulse turret. and one face turret
awaiting orders
on here. Because it would be very beneficial to have one face, iron face, and one, one iron pulse and one face turret in one group. That's actually very beneficial. And I don't want to have like iron pulse on the top and then face turrets at the bottom. That just does not work. And now I need to. And now I need to make a, what's that called? What is that? What is that? What is the thing that I'm not doing? Forgot in every language. Compromises. Now I need to do to make compromises. What's the thing that I'm not doing? Trading and targeting. Cargo drones? Yeah, sure. Get 5 cargo drones. Get some mining drones. And get yourself some service crew. But not too many. Just like 25. 5 million! And we need hull parts. Welp. Whatever. Do it. Give me one. Give me at least one. Porpoise. Porpoise gas miner. Let's see. Yep, that's a difference that I take. That's a difference that I take too. Iron pulse, flight, long range, basic, targeting and trading, flares, captain, service crew, safe, standard. Dum 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 dum. Oh, we have a standard build. Nice. What is it? What's the standard build? Ah, no. Save that as a standard build. Trading and targeting. Full crew. Full flares. Override. And we just need like, oh, I can only get 10. Okay. No money anymore. Ooh. Down to 2,000. Just bought ships for 20 million credits. All right.
Autopilot.
Nothing else to do.
Engaged.
Nothing else to do there. We need money. I need money. The humming in old, not Owen humming on the bonus track. I guess that would be Alexei himself. The humming voice is of a programming colleague who had just joined Eaglesoft the week before Alexei. Ah, interesting. Oh, that's nice. Now the X4 game will insult you regularly, like not enough brain power to complete the
entering
mission.
System, watchful gaze.
I hope there won't be too much competitiveness. I can see a team of sweat just ruining the experience for casual teams. I love that I can spend 17 brain fuel to speed up getting 10 brain fuel. Miners should max out service crew, yes. Especially when you mine silicon, okay. You play new beta with multiverse? Withhold, we just took a look. We just took a look and I reverted into the 6.0 save game. What's a good loadout for the Hydra? I like this loadout, but it's not said that this is the best loadout. It's very good loadout, though. It works good. Ah, cool. There you go. I'm going to save that right now. I'm going to save that reply. For any possible video. Okay, great. Going to listen to Brain Power. Brains. And now... No, where's my chat? Where are you? Ah, it's going into the void. Ah.
Entering system. Heretics.
I install now. Great. Okay.
Autopilot, disengage.
Arthur, okay. 16 kilometers. Sarun, welcome on board. It feels like we're already streaming like for 5 hours, but it has not even been 3.
Headquarters. Docking granted.
Wrap your headquarters. Wait, where did I build the Bourne stuff? There? It's not doing anything. It's not doing anything. Do you even have a builder? Yes, there's a builder. Do you have like stuff already? Ooh, stuff. Look at that, stuff. Even hull parts. Are you kidding me? How did you get hull parts? Oh, and we need... Oh, I forgot. Oh my god. I don't want to do it, but I need to. I will mess with everything now. We need... energy cells. I don't know. I don't know. Usually I could just simply put them here. That's like a good way to use that space. You know? Yeah, let's do one. Confirm. Can you build that, like, first? That would be great. Okay, like, move this. Donk. Move this again. Donk. And now the energy cell production is at the top. Great. Oh boy, no money. You were raging while building the station. Egosoft was hiding in the time from you. Absolutely.
Short range transporter B.
I think so too. What the? Criminals on my station.
Successfully docked.
It's an honor to have you aboard.
All right.
Hydra, Regal.
Regal.
Hello there.
You know what would be nice if you would if you would send a bottle of Shiva's Regal and just make a sticker with Hydra and just put it on top of Shiva's and then you have Shiva's Regal. Oh, come on. Where's the dude? Dude? Boron's raging. Come on. Wait, can we build something? Spacesuit bombs. We can do spacesuit EMPs. And we can do caviar. Craft. And spacesuit bombs. Spacesuit bombs. Wait. Cancel. EMP. Craft. Bomb. Craft. Awesome. Let's go into the laboratory. Save and reload and then dude appears. Ah, that doesn't work. Not all the time. They all ran and hid when they saw me coming. They know that I was raging last time I was at the station. Like throwing build plants around. Firing engineers. Firing architects. Everyone's gone now.
How's it going? So, here's what I've learned from the Alliance of the Word about the reconnected systems. The outcasts and criminals seek safe haven with the free families, while the proud families organize under the High Patriarch, Xyarth. The patriarchal court is quite aloof and too isolated to interfere. A lot of well-connected parties try to influence politics there, and as political outsiders, we won't stand a chance. The free families, however, are a messy bunch. Political structures here are quite obscure, but they also are not as established. Nevertheless, they are a formidable force and can turn the tide for the split. This is why we need to establish better connections there, to learn how to use the political situation for our benefit. It won't be easy. From what I've gathered, most split are not particularly keen on working with outsiders.
One second. There we go. That's better at the moment. Greg, if you're still in here. Greg, if you're still in here. And I don't know if you're responsible for that or not, but high pass filter for band. Band has got sometimes a very deep voice and you need a high pass filter for that. The Lightmare, welcome on board. Good morning. Or you will blow all our subwoofers. Burned. Burn with brains, with brain fuel. What can I do?
With the reconnection of the gates, there are still some split who are concluding their business here in order to return to their families and culture. In order to learn more about them, you should offer a ship as a means of transport.
Uh-huh. Very random split to make friends.
Of course not. I have found one split in particular who, I suspect, is well connected with either the free families or the patriarchy occupation there. He aroused some suspicion. Apparently, he makes the trip regularly under different names, so he could be some sort of smuggler who potentially has ties to the other side. You should help him out in order to learn more about him. Maybe befriend him in order to make him share his connections.
Be careful not to accidentally join his unlawful smuggling operation while transporting him.
That's all I have for you at the moment.
Tunks. Tell me about your plan while I'm quickly going to the bathroom.
I'll take a ship to their trade station to learn more about the intricacies of their economy. Bozo will help me work through their data.
I must say, I am quite curious on what can be deduced from reading company registrations and financial movements.
Okay, I'm back. Bozo. Never. So apparently someone shut the door today to our shared kitchen here in the office building. And now I don't have access to the microwave. I will need to eat my food today cold. Tomorrow, by the way, what did that... that anime girl said, Yamete kudasai. Shut the door. Shut. No. Someone shut the door down. Someone shut the door up. Anyway, yeah. Tomorrow is my last stream in the office in this here. Woo. Actually, we should do something special, but I don't know. I'm just so tired that I can't think of anything. Well, if you have an idea, write me something in the suggestion box on Discord. If you have an idea for the last stream in this office. Break the kitchen door. Actually, yeah, I'm ready.
He requests to be transported in an S-size ship.
Cooking stream
I'll
in there.
I'll update you on his position as soon as I know more.
I don't have an HDMI cable that's so long. Warships? Review the community station builds. And rate them. We could make a... I could possibly make it happen that we raid ships. That we raid all the Boron ships. And then maybe on top of that, all the others too. I don't know. Explode more leftovers. What happens if you put a floppy disk in a microwave? I don't have a floppy disk. Take control of an S-sized chip. Okay, no problem. I do have Barracuda here. Oh, and I deposited some inventory items. No, wait, not storage. Here. Inventory, storage. Yeah, there you go. Okay, thanks. Did I get that stuff now? Yeah. Yeah. And when I say yeah, I actually mean Y-A. Yeah. Not yeah. No, whatever. Barracuda! It will just take hours to get anywhere with the Barracuda, but fine. S-class ship, it has to be. S-class ship, it will be. Wait, Barracuda. Oh, here. Nice. Did you fix that? Hey, great job. Yeah, you fixed it.
Got a lock on his current location. Transmitting data now.
Hello.
Hello. I'm not saying yeah, I'm saying yeah. Yeah. I'm not saying J-A, I'm saying Y-A. Yeah. Instead of yeah. The builder takes forever to get auto there, but whatever.
Engaged.
Where's the builder? Still not here. That walrus takes forever. Forever, ever? Forever, ever? Do we have money? What if I confirm that? Ow! Ouch! Huh. Huh. Okay, any ship already... Oops, any ship already done? Guess my not a single ship is done yet. Someone was lying to me yesterday, I think, by saying that the Queendom is fine with resources and everything. They can sustain, they don't need anything. Yeah, sure.
Entering
like
system.
That dolphin is in that list for more than 12 hours in-game time.
Captain, VO0707. Just subscribed. Welcome to the new spaceman.
0707. GVO, thank you so much for the prime. Very much appreciate it. Thank you very much. Means yeah, no, no. Doesn't it all just mean the same in the end? Exactly.
Autopilot.
Yeah, yes, disengage. Yeah, yo, yep, yarp, 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 narp.
Remember, he's kind of fishy, so be on your toes.
Fishy?
Also, we are trying to befriend him, so try not to make him feel uncomfortable.
Fishy? I know my way around people that are fishy.
Docking granted.
Ever? Thank you, GVO. Thank you very much.
Tourbus A.
Nice. Ooh, secure 8 secure containers. Wow. That was perfect. Oh, Zypex, thank you.
Ah. Successfully done.
Do you have more hydrations waiting? Wait.
Welcome.
Since Arthur Hydra. No. I got water today. I can't even put my non-alcoholic beer in the fridge to make it cold. That's not possible today because the kitchen is closed. Ugh. This is a rage day today. What's going on? Zypax, thank you for the hydration. Cheers. Raising my fist at everything in here and in there. Not you, but in there, here. So there, but.
Thanks for your help.
Hello. Get some British warm air. Oh. Sorry. Ask someone to open build manager, building manager. Yeah, they refuse to put a lock in there so that everyone can open it. Isn't it crazy? Alcohol-free beer. Yeah, it's not really beer. It's like an...
Hello there.
It's like an beer-like beverage. It's hard to describe if you don't know it. Schleichwerbung. It's like beer, but it's sweet. And no alcohol. Malt beverage. Bread flavored soda. It's not really bread flavored. It's okay. Well, yeah.
Can I help?
And Toast, welcome on board.
Here you go.
Tastes really, really nice. I like it. That's the stuff you get served as a kid in Germany to already get used to the taste of beer.
Good luck out there.
Smart strategy there. Almost as good as coffee. Yeah. But not when it's warm. This is not when it's warm. Maybe I just lay it outside the window. It's 6 degrees outside. That's okay. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Greetings. Obi, your transport.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Split. Going to meet Ken.
Oh, isn't that the Splork? No, we will find the Splork later. I'd like to hear more about
right.
them.
Right. Split can humor you with some stories.
Yeah, please.
Ask.
On slavery.
Oh yes. Split civilization has long slave tradition. Split not look kindly upon weaklings, be it foreign creatures or own kin. You seem concerned about slaves' fate. Maybe you interested in some news? Argon slaves heard that their home
invigorated. Was reconnected. Oh, yeah.
They grew insurgent, so patriarchy started pushing slave rights to calm them. Of course, that goes against free families.
Huh. Nice offer. Nice. Nice.
Argon Federation is demanding end to enslavement of Argon, but cannot go into every split household and take their slaves.
I will let that one slide, but just to remind you, your mission was to befriend him.
Ask!
Zypax, there's your answer in Discord.
Patriarchal split are traditional. Politics follow Tharuk's way. Zyarth, patriarch of all split, unites all lesser patriarchs under his rule.
Player is the biggest slaver in X4 with a one-time buy screw.
The patriarch is a survivalist, always on the move. He made a name for himself fighting Xenon invaders. His Zyarth family was thriving in the outer reaches. Then Patriarch Roncar failed to keep the Empire together. Zyarth stepped in to prevent the great families from drifting apart. After the gate realignments, he had outlived all his former competitors. And now there is barely a split alive who would remember another patriarch on the throne.
Whoa, where did... Where did Dahl came from here? Funny stuff. By the way, just to make sure, this is not true, okay? Just to make sure, this is a message in Discord. This is not true. Wait, where is it? Wah. Not true. Funny.
Given how long he has to reign, do not expect him to be gone anytime soon.
By Bozo, don't question the future of what could be his government.
By Bozo.
Any more questions? Outcasts, exiles, and cursed ones, such as the
no upkeep, no.
Cure. It's more of a slum than an economy.
Really. There are mods for upkeep, but not in the base game. Hey Zerksauce, good morning.
The disgraced family responsible for a reactor incident on a shipyard. We still remember our dead every anniversary. May they haunt that cursed family for all eternity.
Family to Gur.
Some of the families do not want patriarchal laws in their realm, and local pirates are similarly reluctant to accept proper government.
So this guy bought into the patriarchal propaganda. Be careful. We don't want to alienate him.
That's enough. Time to go now.
Curse these split. What a neck. Hello.
Hello.
Show me your live stream. And she's like, okay, here. Why do I see that when I do the live? Wait, what? Not the live stream I'm looking for.
I'm aboard your ship and ready to go.
How the heck are you so fast, huh? Shift D. Any criminal? Oh, criminal? Well, the builder itself will not be enough, but yeah, basically you can do this if you want to. Great. Secure containers. Algae scrubber.
Autopilot. Well, engaged.
At least some reputation. Nyeow. Where are you going? Autopilot, where are you going?
Autopilot, engage.
I am. Aya! Thank you so much, Clovius, for following and being follower number 6,700. We're moving so fast at the moment. This channel is like...
Thank you.
Moving... the fastest since Cradle of Humanity. Last time so much stuff happened in here was because of Cradle of Humanity. Thank you very much. Even the game thanks you. Yeah. No, the game thanks you. Not me. You. You? No, me. You. This is you. And this is me. You? Me? wonderful movie. Okay. This time, the premiere will run. And this time, we will not be interfered. Okay. It is a nice ship, yeah. Mega, welcome aboard. This is a Barracuda. Though it is fairly slow. Oops. It's fairly slow because like travel speed around 3,000 meters per second. That's really not that much. You see the Mega, thank you so much for following. And you see the acceleration, it's not that much. Arthur, lol. Alright, had to make that clear. What is going on in Discord at the moment? Wait, what was that? Xenon. No, I don't care.
Entering system. Silent witness.
I've hit the space bar 37 times in a row now, but I still remain on Earth. Wait, what? Anyone has information about the next SpaceX
disengage.
Launch?
Entering
when
system.
Are they going to try it?
Perfect.
Tomorrow?
Alpha.
Today? Tonight? Morning? Is there a new time? Oh my god.
Entering system. Bright promise.
Huh.
Entering system. Trinity Sanctum.
All right. In about 4 minutes or so for next launch. Wait, what? No. Really?
Entering system. Unholy retribution.
Oh no, that's a Starlink mission.
Entering system.
No. No audio this time. No audio this time. You're not going to fool me again, SpaceX. Okay, there's apparently a Falcon 9 launch, but that's not what I was asking for. I was asking for the Starship launch. If there is another Starship launch. There's actually Falcon 9 in 3 minutes.
Entering
Starship is
system.
Tomorrow.
Pontifex's claim.
Ah. It's your video processed now. Yeah, the video is... So, with the video from yesterday, why was there
system.
No premiere yesterday again? My video got flagged because of 27 seconds of audio during the SpaceX launch thingy. They used some music. The music got flagged, I think, unrightfully. So I think this was very scammy. And
entering system. True sight.
I had to remove it somehow. I did let YouTube handle that. I thought so. That's a good idea. But the processing took more than 12 hours and then I just simply cancelled it. So I took the stream from that day, cut it myself, rendered it, uploaded it again, and now it's finally available tonight. So yeah, that was kind of a hassle to get that stuff done.
Entering system, Argon Prime.
I see a spaceship out my window. I forget it's not the spaceship. Wait, what? Spaceship SpaceX targeting April 20 for the next Starship launch attempt. The 62-minute launch window opens
Entering
Thursday.
System. Atikva's choice.
Oh, that's a good time, actually. That's tomorrow again during the stream. You're 7 miles from the launch pad? 7 miles? It's like that thing starts and drops and it's like, hey, I got a Starship in my backyard. Da-dum. So please no spoilers about Starlink.
Entering system. Silent witness.
Chat is disabled for this live stream. I should do that too sometimes. Great view, but boy do I hear the 3 a.m. launches. Wow. Oh my god. Like they're launching a lot lately, right? Like those Falcon 9
entering
launches,
system.
These are regular
Rocket
now.
Center Alpha.
Like you have like every 2 weeks you have a launch. It's crazy. When NASA was doing that, they had like what, how many launches a year? Five or whatever? I don't know. Just assuming. There we go. It's starting.
Entering system. Bright promise.
Vehicle is pitching downrange. Stage one propulsion is nominal.
Entering system. Trinity Sanctum.
Okay, cool. Look, that's how I built my last rocket in Kerbal Space Program 2.
Unholy retribution.
See? 30 seconds and they already have like a few degrees. 5 degrees or something. 5 to 10 degrees.
Power and telemetry nominal. And we are
entering system. IS mists.
Boom shakalaka!
And just heard that call out that Falcon 9
supersonic.
Is supersonic. That means that the vehicle is traveling faster than the speed of sound. We are coming up on max Q here in a few seconds.
Faster than the speed of sound.
Max Q.
Max Q, this is the
max Q.
Most important part.
Now, next up are a few events happening back to back. That will be Miko stage seven.
Entering system.
Antique's not here. He's like watching it from his window.
Miko is main engine cutoff. That's where we'll shut down all of those engines.
Entering system.
What the?
Bully vision.
We will shut down all those engines that you on the vehicle right now. And that'll prepare the vehicle for stage separation.
Give me what? Where's the
autopilot? Engaged.
Again, we are scheduled to land on a shortfall of gravitas today. And stage two will continue with SES-1, or second stage engine start one. And that's where we will ignite the MVAC engine on the second stage.
This looks so crazy.
MVAC ignition, we will also separate the fairing, and the two fairing halves will fall back down.
I'm awake.
Entering system. Pontifex's claim.
The launches aren't bad, but the ones that land here always surprise me.
Entering
oh,
system.
Wow, okay.
IS mists.
Crazy. What is this?
Main engine cutoff. Stage separation confirmed.
Mako. Mako, main engine cutoff.
MVAC ignition.
Entering system.
And
unholy retribution.
Miko's stage separation and the ignition of the MVAC engine. You can see the first stage on your left-hand screen. The grid fins are now deploying with an awesome view.
That always blows my mind when they use just
entering
aluminum
system.
Foil around those engines. Just simple aluminum foil. Not that the thing's like going 7,000 kilometers per hour. No, there's like a little bit of aluminum foil around it.
Entering system.
It's like,
right,
okay.
Promise.
Really cool view of the fairing being separated from the second stage. We
autopilot. Disengage. Entering
crazy.
System.
Yeah, if it would be like
Alpha.
Would be any visible outside, no clouds or whatever. This is like I once saw that happening during nighttime in Germany. And you could see the satellites like in a line flying by. That was really cool. And then the next time they appeared, they were already spread out more.
System.
And that was really nice.
Again, you are looking at your left hand side is the first stage. On your right-hand side is the second stage, looking at our MBAC engine.
Hey, Beta Crank, welcome aboard! Because I heard lots of good stuff about X4. Stage but one, heck, where does one start as a total X4 noob? That's a good question. With the game start. With the tutorials and with just one game start and you just take a look around. Since it's a single-player game, there's absolutely no pressure for you to do anything. You will not be harassed by any other players. You can take your time. If you want to do something and it will take you 100 hours, it will take you 100 hours. Nobody cares because it's your own enjoyment. So, it's absolutely up to you, Beta. What I always tell new players is do not put pressure on yourself to know everything from the start. Enjoy the experience and the way of doing and learning things.
Entering system, Argon Prime.
Stage one making its way back down to Earth.
Lower the video audio by 20%. Why that?
On your screen, on your left hand
screen. The video audio.
There are four on the vehicle. These help.
Entering system. Second contact.
Yeah, I mean, can we jump forward? Can we please like jump forward? Okay, there's nothing really that much happening anymore. Why is the autopilot not
entering system?
Why is the autopilot not working?
Entering system. Second contact.
I passed that two times already.
To provide high speed, low latency internet autopilot engaged locations around the globe.
There you go.
Entering system.
That should work.
Argon Prime.
That should work.
Coming up here shortly will be the entry burn for the first stage vehicle. This will be 3 of 9 engines reigniting.
Entering system. Take fast choice.
Stage one entry burn startup.
And there you can see on your left-hand screen, the engines have reignited. This is just under a 20-second burn and helps to slow the vehicle down as it's...
Oh, stage one telemetry, stage two telemetry. 15,000 kilometers per hour. Wow. And still accelerating. And staying at the same altitude.
Stage two FTS has saved.
160 kilometers. That's not much.
Entering system. Silent witness.
It's really not much.
The first stage used to launch our 21 V2 mini Starlink satellites into space today is flying for the 8th time.
17,000 kilometers per hour.
Hakuto R mission 1, Hispasat Airborne.
Entering
Arizona,
system,
Nexus,
Profit Center
CRS
Alpha.
CRS-27 and 3 Starlink missions.
So this is now accelerating to get the periapsis up, right? To have like... They are now flying basically at the apoapsis, and they're trying to get the periapsis up, right? With this. I mean, if I learned anything out of Kerbal Space Program, that's what they were trying to do, achieve orbit, right? Crazy. That's so crazy. 20,000 kilometers per hour. Oh, look, they're past the apoapsis. They're going down a little bit.
Now we will have second engine cut off.
Start of terminal guidance.
Very shortly after stage one
stage
landing.
Stage one landing burn.
Cool.
And there's that landing burn.
Is KSP2 playable by now? I don't know. It was playable for a long time, but oh, this is the craziest part of all of that. This is the absolute craziest part.
Landing like deploy.
I mean, it's like...
Stage one and landing confirmed.
It's like the...
And some cheers the
accuracy of that thing. And almost hit the X there. The accuracy is just so insane. Look at that. Like as if nothing happened. Hey, KSP. Look at that.
And great call out there. We had second engine cutoff one as well as a call out for a good nominal insertion.
That's how KSP needs to look like. I want to change the map with my mouse. 9 minutes and the stage is back. 9 minutes. Put something in orbit. Like, what the heck?
And second engine cutoff. That wraps up our coverage for now. Be sure to check out
Captain
social media.
Joe underscore from underscore work. Just subscribed. Welcome to the new spaceman.
Joe from work, thank you very, very much. That was crazy. 9 minutes going up and it's back. Casually. I guess if nothing happened. Perfect landing. Almost on the spot. Missed it for about like 50 centimeters. Fine. Nice Wednesday morning. It's like, that's how far we are already. Crazy. Absolutely crazy. Blows my mind. Okay, find a way to 2 grand. Wait, that's up. No. Yeah. Up. That's up. Up. Do we have satellites? Yeah. Great. Then let's place some satellites. Actually, you know what? Yeah, we do that ourselves.
Autopilot engaged.
I'm glad I got to catch you live. I don't get too often. Thank you very much, Joe. Very much appreciated. Thank you so much. Mind that Kerbin has less mass than Earth. Griffin, welcome on board. Tomorrow will be a lot bigger. Yeah, we thought already that we hoped for that like 2 days ago already. Stuck the landing, yeah. CGI is crazy these days. I was just in space and back. No, actually not really in space. 160 kilometers. I don't think you can call that space.
Autopilot disengaged.
It's still... Isn't it still part of the atmosphere? Miles. Oh, thank you. Nobody's using miles. Where are kilometers? There. Thermosphere. It's still called thermosphere. And then there's the exosphere, where there usually are satellites, but this is just 160 kilometers. Maybe they're going a little bit more up. I don't know. So yeah, but space would be more than 3,000 kilometers. Yeah. That's there, yeah. Above 1,000 is considered space. Let me put some satellites up before we continue. Shield component. Advanced electronics. Claytronics engine parts. Ooh, nice. Yeah, easy.
Autopilot engaged.
Above 100 kilometers is considered space. 100 kilometers is like that. It's not really that much. Like, if you think about it, it's like our atmosphere is like really small.
Autopilot.
Compared to the planet itself, it's like kind of small. 100 kilometers considered tourist space. I don't know. I still consider that like very small. Okay. Let's get a satellite down here.
Autopilot engaged.
Things can orbit around 160. If it's vacuum, it's space. Well, that's the thing. Is it already entire vacuum? So... isn't space itself not a 100% vacuum? Good luck finding an accurate word to define space.
Autopilot disengaged.
I mean, couldn't you say that outer space is like where there's no
autopilot,
where there's no gravity effect of any star anymore? In your Bourne only game, will you pilot the Earth King? No. Nope. Between the stars. Between the What mods do you use? None at the moment. None at the moment, but I do have some mods in the last playthrough. Link is in chat. What is this?
One of the main missions of the International Space Station is to provide us a way to learn what it's going to take for humans to live in space long term. And that covers everything from what the absence of gravity does to astronauts' bones and muscles, and also all the way down to more simple things like what it's like to drink a glass of water in orbit. The Dragon cargo ship that arrived at the station last week is carrying an experiment known as the Cap.
Of how we can do this in a day-to-day, you know, living in space kind of way.
So that's just a very practical example of the research you've been doing, right?
The design models that we use for industrial design or commercial aerospace or NASA-related aerospace stuff, bring it all together in a cup. And the geometry is complicated, and but it can be 3D printed. The galley just drinking like this. So once the connection is made with the lip, the entire contents can be drained into the mouth. It'll be pretty much like a drinking experience. The nose will be centered over the opening, so you'll get a nice whiff of whatever it is. It'll feel somewhat like Earth. It'll be different.
Oh. So yeah, double thingy here. What the heck? What? I stick with my brains. I'm okay with brains. Satellite. Okay, great. We have coverage. There's the gate. We have coverage of this system. Most important stuff is covered. Engine parts, advanced electronics, shipyard, wharf, equipment dock. All right. Horosuk, welcome aboard. Usually means outside the heliopause. Vacuum means a space entirely devoid of matter or a vacuum cleaner. An adventure. I like that. Okay, wait, what's going on here? What is this mess? Xenon? Missile component engine parts. Ooh, wow. Programmable field array, that's 100k. That's another 100k. Okay, well, let's grab that. The heck? Oh no, it's going away! No!
Buzzard, Vanguard. Container.
Going away! Was that the right one?
Container.
I don't know.
Container.
Is that the right one? I don't know. Yes, programmer field array. Okay, great. At least one of them. Okay. What's going on here? Why are there so many Xenon coming through that gate? This is a gate to Grant, not to Matrix number 9 or something.
This is sector security.
Damn it.
Split scan now. What you have?
Have I not warned my assistant to not become an accomplice in an unlawful conveyance of goods?
It's rather odd to come across patriarchy police in this sector. Wait, let your passenger deal with this.
This is Foul Tenant reporting on behalf of Scanned Vessel.
Captain.
This one has some dangerous opinions.
Ah! I'm just a boring floating around. Leave me. Please.
Barracuda.
Leave me, please. Whoa, whoa, whoa. My goodness.
Since you showed interest in split culture.
Yeah.
Have friend who might talk some sense into you. That reckless split always find trouble. Sending you her contact details.
Well, that was unexpected. Looks Wait. Like our suspect was scouting newcomers for the Xyarth authorities. Connections to the Xyarth
Gate
won't get us anywhere. The contact he provided, however, definitely belongs to the Free Families.
Wow.
I have a possible location for her, but she won't be that easy to actually get hold of.
Great. Okay. And now?
Have a look at this. Recently, there have been a number of slaves who have escaped their former masters.
Lost reputation. -4. What?
This isn't the first instance of slave resistance since the gates opened. News of a strong
rattlesnake
elsewhere has
Let's take that rattlesnake.
This lot, however, decided to take our split friend hostage. Doing her a favor could earn us the friend we need. To land on the fugitive ship, you'll need to be on board an S-size ship. A bigger ship may be perceived as threatening and could complicate the release of the hostage. Be aware that the Patriarchy Police are also looking for this ship.
What a change of events. So, we're undocking, right? Okay, yeah, great.
Your days are numbered.
Requesting immediate backup.
Good. Ah, they removed... I see what they did. They hotfixed the elevator by removing that cover that came out here. Maybe you remember it from the last few days. That was causing a little bit of trouble because it was like... teleporting you about half a meter up, and they just simply remove that cover. Okay, I don't know if I like that. I like that with cover more, but I guess that's just a hotfix. Don't think that was fixed? Yeah.
Hello.
But it is different. It is different.
M.
Nice.
Container.
Nice. At least we shot one Xenon down today. Heute. Okay. Any other threat?
Autopilot engaged.
Got you on the beta? No, I'm not. I changed back to no beta. 6.0. It took you forever to figure out how to get in your first Bourne ship. Well, to be honest, the first time I got into a Bourne ship was by clicking the elevator, looking up at the elevator, and I'm like, okay, this is new. I was clicking at the elevator. There's been any fixes yet? Weird. So this just happened on its own? Like some, did you implemented some random AI that is fixing itself? That will be it. Introducing the self-repairing AI game. Don't question it. It's working. It's working. That's all I need. The elevator might just be in the down position when you were looking at it. No.
This vessel fits the type, but I am not sure if it is indeed the correct one. This one appears to have been abandoned. How strange! You should try to gain entry to it, so that we can extract more details from the ship's internal logs.
I do get a Cobra. I don't like that. Why are we even helping the... Oh, that's not working.
Barracuda.
Why are we even helping the split? We should wreck Chaos. Wait, no, there.
Oh, dearie me, no. Apparently, this vessel was stopped and its crew taken during the invasion by the Patriarchy. This must all have happened before the gates were reconnected. It is clearly the wrong ship. So let us turn our attention to other possible locations for her whereabouts.
The others, right. I have a lot of bulk data, but can't pinpoint a possible location for our fugitives. Sending it over. This sort of riddle should make your senses tingle. Bozo will help you track them down so that you can negotiate the hostage's release.
That is such a Star Wars background.
Dull has provided a considerable number of sensor data logs from ships that have traversed Free Family's sectors on their trade routes. Analyzing the logs and cross-referencing them with cargo records, I was able to identify several vessels worthy of further investigation.
Thank you very much, Joe.
I will mark their positions on your map for you.
Joe, I thought you were already at work. Have a good day at work. Fix it and then sell it. Wait, I cannot fix it? Fix it. Repair tool. Stay. Nice.
Barracuda. Cobra.
Fix it. It's just a background picture. Ah, yeah, good. Is the pair laser for S and M ships for this reason? What's a MD? Ah, mod. Ah, yeah. Repair laser for S and M ships. Well, you just wrote that underneath the guy that did it. error name did the repair laser for S&M ships. Sweet, dude. Sweet. All right, but I think we're done here. Nice. Whoa, what a day. Can you Sita in spacesuit? I think that's only possible because of mods. Yeah. Whoa, what's going on there? There is someone fighting outside. I think I will get deaded in a second. All right. So, saving that game. Save it better. Under attack, the bark. Yeah, I know. All right. Good. Thank you very much for being here. It was a pleasure to be your captain today. Tomorrow is the last day in this office. Ooh, and then we're moving. Also, the last day we play X4 out of the usual time. So we're returning in May to FFXFF. Tomorrow we're still there, 12 p.m. Central European Time. But after that, we're returning to only Fridays again. For X4. Thank you so much for being here. It was a pleasure. Have a wonderful day, night, morning, evening, whatever it is for you. Stay safe and healthy out there. And let's have a few salutes in here. Thank you very much. See you tomorrow. Do some recreation. Tomorrow, all hands back on deck. Have a good one. See you then. Bye-bye. YouTube video later. For 40 days or even more, the line went slack. Then tight once more, our boats were lost. There were only four and still that whale did go. Soon may the weathermen come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. As far as I've heard, the fight's still on. The line's not cut and the whale's not gone. The weatherman makes his regular call to encourage the captain, crew and all. Soon may the weatherman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. Soon may the weatherman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go.
Holy Jesus! What is that? What the fuck is that?